Hello everybody, welcome to Stratoscale Hybrid DevOps Show. I'm Ariel, and with me is Noam.
Yes.
Hi Noam.
How's it going?
So we're going to talk today about installing Symphony. So, Noam, tell us about the installation process.
Yes, we're going to show you how we can deploy a cluster. We currently have four nodes, and we're going to deploy the four nodes, configure it, and we see how easy it is to produce a cluster and already start your VMs, your volumes, or whatever you need.
Fantastic.
Okay, so currently for Symphony, we have four ways to install Symphony. You can do it by ISO, you can do it by disk on key, you can do it by Pixie, or if you want, by an image of QCAL.
Okay, so when we deliver the bits to the platform in order to install them, I can use a USB, or I can do a network-based boot process, various forms.
Yeah. Right. So currently I'll show you a Pixie, because we want to do it in parallel, the four nodes to install. So what we want to do firstly is to deploy our operating system on the four nodes.
Okay.
So we'll need to configure the basic parameters for each node, and afterwards we can configure the cluster and we see how easy it
Fantastic.
To start the cluster. So this is the first node. I'm connected to its serial over LAN, and this will be the first thing you'll see after you boot from Pixie. Okay. First is the EULA. Accept. Because
it's very important to accept the
Yeah, if you don't accept, I'm not sure you're going to have a cluster, yeah? Anyways, we accept, and we have to select the disk we want to install.
Okay, so we see a platform here with three drives, an SSD, and two SATA drives.
Yes. So we want to install our operating system on an SSD, or the most efficient drive that you have on your system. So we can click next. I don't know what other things you had before, but okay, so let's format it all.
In order to foolproof this, we're asking for permission before formatting the drives.
Yes.
Okay, so let's erase these drives.
And if you want to aggregate, let me explain to you. First thing that we want to do, in order to configure the node, configure the cluster, we'll need you to have your access network, so you can access your node by its IP. So if you have a bond that you want to access, if it's a bonded.
So in a bonded environment, we want to set up the bonds beforehand,
so you can access the access IP afterwards.
So I guess that depends on my top of rack switch configuration, if it demands a bond before accepting me or not.
Yeah, so currently we are not using a bond, so we're not aggregating anything.
Okay.
And we're going to select the network interface which we want to access the node, each node individually. So this will be the Ethernet one, Intel base board.
It's my 1 gig, I see network interface.
Yeah. So now, in order to access the node, you will have to configure the static IP. So with this, we're gonna have to, this is the in a routable IP, because you want to access it from outside of your organization, or not from outside, just from your computer, so you can access it. This will be the IP that we're gonna reach the node for initial configuration, and its gateway, which is will be 254, and the DNS server is of course Google, as we can access it from outside. Opa.
Okay.
If you are using a multi cluster environment that you already installed in your environment several clusters, you'll have to provide already now the cluster name. If not, then you don't have to do it. You can do it later when you configure the cluster.
Okay.
Okay. So let's do it now. This password, this is the root password of the machine, which will be whatever you want. And now you can see all the installation parameters, the initial installation that you just wrote and you just configured, and you launch the installation.
Okay, so this is going to install my first node in the environment.
Yeah, and as you can see, now it's a percentage and it will start going up until 100%. It will reboot, and then our operating system will take control, and you'll be able to configure the cluster and the nodes.
Approximately how long does it take?
It depends on how you want to install. If it's disk on key, if it's a fast disk on key, it can take 5 minutes, 8 minutes. If it's Pixie, it also can be very fast. If it's ISO over, I don't know, if your gateway is in China and you're installing in England, then it can take 1 hour, but it depends. But usually it's between 10 minutes to 15 minutes, I think.
Approximately.
And of course, you can see I have another four nodes and I can start install them and I will do it, but I will spare you from this video all the installation and we'll see the configuration next.
Fantastic.
Cool.
Okay. So again, we can install multiple nodes and then aggregate them into the cluster and we'll see that.
Cool.
Okay, great. So let's wait a few minutes and then we can see fresh environment.
Okay. Cool. This is done.
Fantastic.
Okay, so as you can see now, the all four nodes are in different stages of their deployment. This node was the first one to finish, so we're going to use this as to configure the cluster.
Okay, so after all the nodes installed and rebooted, you pick one, and from that we're going to continue.
Yes, so we're using this one. This was the first one. And I must mention that the all nodes, I mean, I'm picking this one to configure the cluster, but the all nodes afterwards are symmetrical. There is no special node, but this one. Okay, so let's go. As you can see, it tells us to, in order to configure the cluster, we have to go to this IP that we configured in the first stage. So we're going to navigate to it. Okay. And we're gonna log into it with the root password of the node, which we set it before, as you remember. And it's this one,
okay.
I think. Great.
All right, so we logged into the first node, and now we can start to configure the cluster.
We have two options. We can configure a cluster or join existing region. Currently, we don't have any existing region, so we're gonna start a new region by pressing, you see this button
start
here.
Start new region.
Yeah. So, host name, we can set it up, it can be automatically if you don't have anything, but we can call it node 0.
Okay.
NTP servers, we can add NTP servers, ntp.ubuntu.com if we want. And next, if we have aggregation, if we have bond types or bonding in our system that we want to use, because we're going to have to define two networks, one for the control network and one for the data network.
Okay.
So currently we're going to use just one interface, the Ethernet one interface, which is the management, is 10 gigs, and it would be both only for the management and also
so
for the data.
We're going to use a single 10 gig interface for all traffic.
Yeah. Okay. And we don't use bond, so we don't need to configure
this
anything.
This environment is
here.
Not bonded.
Yeah. So let's do it. This is our interface that we're going to use. We're going to use VLAN that is already dedicated in our switch, and we're going to just use the CIDR, whatever we wish to use, because it's internal, so it's not important. I mean, it will be important for the cluster, but not for outside world, because it's just internal. And node IP pool we don't want, because our Symphony will automatically assign IPs to the nodes, whatever is needed. Data traffic, the same as control traffic, to be the same one with a different VLAN. We don't want it to be interception.
Okay, so we're going to segregate the data traffic from the control plane traffic.
Yeah, so again, with the subnet as well. A different subnet. VLAN range, this will be the VLANs that the guest network will use. That if you want to create a VPC, a network, the VLAN will be deduct from these values. So currently, we just want to open it to all VLANs, let's say, something like this. And the most important for the admin is how to connect to the cluster. This will be the IP, the northbound IP, the endpoint IP that you will access and you will do whatever you need in the cluster.
Mm-hmm.
So this has to be routable, of course. And we're going to use the gateway as well. /254 and before you start, you just make sure that all the parameters that you did were correct, and we're going to start a cluster and the region has been successfully configured. Now we're going to wait for our services to start, and the region in several minutes, 2-3 minutes, it will be ready for joining other nodes and starting workloads and whatever is needed.
Okay, so after we configured a single node as the seed for the region, we're now waiting for it to start, and then we'll be able to add additional nodes.
So let's just see the other screen of adding additional node.
Okay.
Okay, we're going to just look at the serial overline to see that we finished. Here, this guy is already also finished. So we're going to just go. You don't have to do it unless you, because now, I mean, if we want to go to the installer of each node, it's just to configure. Now we don't need to configure cluster, just the node itself means only bonds is or host name, like things like this. You don't have to do it, but let's just see how.
Okay, so if we need to do specific node configuration, we can log in into each node separately. If we just want to pull them into the cluster,
we can just go to the cluster itself, which will go further on.
Okay,
and then
let's take a look at that.
Okay, cool. So now we're going to do in the 64. Okay, so I'm just going to change it right here, and so we're going to push the join existing region. We're going to join the region to join will be the same one that we configured. It's the same name and bonding. We don't need no bond, so finish. And now we are ready to join. You don't have to push it, just if you need, and that's it. Soon, and then now we're going to connect to the Northbound IP, the API endpoint, and we're going to add the other nodes to the cluster, and we'll see how the cluster is assembled.
Fantastic.
Cool. Okay, so now, as you see, we logged in into the API endpoint that we configured when we configured the cluster, and we can log into our Symphony cluster. Let's see it.
Okay. So that's the IP address that we got as a northbound IP for the cluster.
The endpoint IP of the cluster. This is how you will manage your cluster. We're using our default credentials. Of course, you can change it. You can add users. You can do whatever. This is another session you'll see. And we allow Symphony. And we want to see.
Okay, so we logged into a cluster based on that single node that we created.
Yeah.
Now what do we do?
So now we want to assemble the clusters so we can consist all the four nodes or X nodes, whatever your cluster needs. Okay. So currently we installed four nodes, as you remember.
Yep.
They all finished their installation. We're going with the control K shortcut to node section.
Okay.
And we will see three nodes as candidates.
Ah, interesting. So we see node zero that we configured and three other nodes that were installed but not configured yet.
Yeah. As you can see, the IPs that we configured, these will be the access IP.
Got it.
Okay. And you can see the CPU is starting running because we're running all of our services on just this node currently. Once we will add the all other nodes into the cluster, balancing of the services will occur and all nodes will take the same balance more or less.
Fantastic. So, okay, so I can add nodes to the cluster now. Is there a way to do that with a wizard?
Yeah. You simply go to help, and if you go to getting started, then it will just guide you on the steps you need to do. And this is, you can see, you can accept the nodes. Let's click this one at least.
Accept it.
And accept it.
I see.
And I'll go back to the nodes cluster to accept them all one by one. I can highlight it and accept it from here. And highlight this and accept it from here. And now they're activating. Soon they will be active in the cluster. And then you have your cluster and you can start working on it.
So I configure one node. I start pulling in additional nodes. My cluster grows.
Yeah.
And have an instant AWS compatible private cloud environment.
Yeah, that's and it's very easy to add other nodes as you wish. One, you just following the same procedure, just accept the other nodes and
you can scale it up. That's how you install a Symphony cluster.
Thank you.